Sir, am I audible?
Yes, audible.
Yes, audible.
Video?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Good evening to one and all present here. On behalf of the PG and Research Department of Commerce, Shift 1 of Patrician College of Arts and Science, I welcome you all the 7-day International Professional Development Program. And it's day 3 PDP on statistical package for social science. And today's topic is on chi-square test. And it is also called as goodness of fit. It's our culture to remember the God Almighty before everything we do or start. So let us begin this function seeking the blessing and presence of the God Almighty. So now I invite our PG representative from 2nd MCOM, Ms. Tiana, to lead us in prayer.
Thank you, Pooja. Almighty God, we thank you for helping us see the light of another beautiful day. May we learn to use this day to the fullest in doing all that we can do. Lord, we place the resource person and the participants in your care. Fill us with knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Open up our hearts and minds to grasp the teachings of today. Bless the entire team organizing this program for their tireless efforts in bringing forward this program. Keep everyone safe and productive during these trial times. We make this prayer in your name, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Diana. Our chi-square testing is a hypothesis testing method. Two common chi-square tests involve checking of observed frequencies in one or more categories match expected frequencies. Well, I'm not expert at this, but we do have wonderful person in our midst who can help us to understand this concept and use in a simpler way. So now I invite Mr. S. Arunan, sir, Assistant Professor of Commerce, to introduce our resource person from today.
Thank you, Puskala Pooja. Good evening, everyone present here. Today, we are here to listen and learn on cipher test, the only aspect which can be applied for smaller as well as large samples for testing qualitative data. It is a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker, Dr. G. Shanmugasundaram, retired professor, Department of Commerce, Pondicherry University. The resource person of the day has a distinguished career in academics, research, guidance in research, proficiencies in varied information technologies, conduct of outreach programs, industrial experiences, contribution to the nation, advance provided to assistance provided to medical research students, etc. 25 of his articles have been published in varied national and international journals, books, proceedings, etc. under the areas of industrial finance, stock and bond markets, and foreign exchange market. He is on the board of publishing for prestigious Lombard publications. His contribution for the publication board adds management of working capital, finance management for MBA, Pondicherry University, accounting and finance for managers, solved the question paper for MBA, IGNO, has witnessed additional editions. The project he undertook includes ICSSR and UGC, 12 medical research programs, and has took part in various conferences across the nation. The effective workshops organized by our resource person has gained significance throughout the country. His contributions extend to his own department and covers university at large under the activities of conduct of exams, number of board of studies, resource personnel, and much more privileged involvements. The proficiencies in information technology includes SPSS, AVOs, AMOS, Smart PLS, etc. SAR is also associated with IIBF for 15 years for imparting the knowledge of financial accounting and management accounting in Pondicherry chapter. His industrial experience finds place in mutual fund certification and NSE certification while undergoing His third refresher course, Sir was promoted to Lieutenant Commander in 2002. Sir is the recipient of the prestigious Commendation Award from Directorate of General of NCC, New Delhi, for 25 years of service rendered successfully in the Indian NCC Navy. Thank you, sir, for accepting our invitation, and we all welcome you. Once again, thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Dear participant, please post your queries in chat box. Now, I heartily welcome our resource person, Dr. G. Shanmugasundaram, sir, retired professor from Pondicherry University. We are eagerly waiting with open mind to grab the knowledge which you are about to impact to us. And the session is yours, sir.
Good evening to everybody. Dr. Unica, head of the department, then coordinator of this program, 7 days program, Dr. Aram Thurayarasan, Prushottaman, Kamala Devi, and other team members. Again, I am saying that this program is a very good one for this development of research, improvement of research in all over India. First of all, I thank the organizer for giving an opportunity to stand or sit before that technology and giving and importing the knowledge of PDP program with the help of SPSS. Today, I am going to present my session under the three headings. Each and every presentation over, session is over, I am ready to answer the question for the respondent raised so that they will be clear when I am going for second session and the subsequent session. Therefore, my humble request to the respondent, you please post your queries and doubts then and there, so I can easily clear your doubts. Whatever the doubts which you want to clear, you please make it in the post. I will clear your doubts when the first session is over, half an hour. The second session is another half an hour. The third session is another half an hour. Then fourth session, another half an hour, that is 6 o'clock, the session will be over. And that last session, the participant can fire me with the help of their academic questions. During the session, even sometime I can also fire some questions with you. That is only for exploring the knowledge of research. But at the same time, you don't want to give the answer, but you try to find out the answer during the course of your research, but do not expect from me. Whatever the question which is raised by you, I will answer. But whenever I am raising a question against you, you cannot post any question on that. You can find out the answer for yourself. Okay, so the question may be a participant or any supervisor or guide. Whoever may be interested, let them put whatever the question which you may post. I don't mind. So my session, I'm going to take three parts, session 1, 2, 3 separately. How I am going to lay out my session, that all I will tell you during the first session. So now I'm going for sharing the screen. Are you getting the screen?
No, sir. You just click the share screen on the right hand side. There is your option share. Yes, sir. Now I am getting, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Right. Yes. Yes. See, when Uday Suryan approached me asking as a resource person to present in the program, he had given all the list of the topics. Though I am very familiar about all the topics, but I have chosen the chi-square test, which everyone feel it is very simple. But many of the researchers are doing the maximum mistake in the chi-square test, which I want to expose the mistake, which they should not commit such a mistake in the future. That is why I selected this chi-square test. Whenever I am taking this session, during the course of session, I will point out what are the problems which actually the researchers are doing the mistake. First mistake which I will point out, all the research scholars invariably throughout in India, they used to say chi-square test. They are used to say chi-square test. This itself is the wrong one, because the chi-square test is a common noun. It is a common noun. Many of the researchers never informed in their research what is the proper noun. You take, for example, t-test. T-test is a common noun wherein you can go for one sample t-test, two sample t-test, and a paired t-test. As a researcher, you must give in research methodology, are you going to apply one sample t-test or two sample t-test or paired t-test? You cannot say simply a common noun which is called t-test. That is a wrong way of presenting your research methodology. So therefore, first of all, how do you present the name of the test in your chi-square test? You must know as a research scholar. The chi-square test is a common noun wherein what are the proper noun, in the sense there are different types of tests which are coming under this chi-square test. What are they? Let us go for these things. These tests are, the proper nouns are chi-square test for goodness of fit. One. Number two. Chi-square test for association. Number three, the chi-square test for homogeneity. So there are three proper nouns are there within the common noun of chi-square test, but no researcher which write in the research methodology, I am going to apply chi-square test for goodness of fit or association or homogeneity. They can simply say what? Chi-square test. Chi-square test. Let the examiner knows whether I am going to apply goodness of fit or association or homogeneity. Let the examiner, let them say, find out. I don't want to give the exact test. So this is the attitude of the research scholar, which never give in the research methodology what is the exact test which we want to apply. So my humble request to all the participants, research scholars, ladies and gentlemen, please inform the research methodology in chi-square test, which I am going to apply, goodness of fit test or test of association or test of homogeneity. Like that, they must specify in the research methodology, unless otherwise it is very bad in the research part. So I'm going to take three sessions, one chi-square test for goodness of fit, one test session for half an hour, chi-square test for association for another half an hour, chi-square test for homogeneity for third half an hour session. So that is the way which I'm going to present my session. So each and every session is ogaya. You can post the question during this half an hour session. I will clear your doubts so that your confidence, your mind will be very clear to go for this bloody chi-square test for association. Once the chi-square test of association ogaya, post your questions, I will clear your doubts. Then we will go for chi-square test for homogeneity. So this is the way which you want to. I am planning my layout. Okay, so see, in the last two session, I was also in the online and listening the first session, second session, and I came to know what actually your requirements, what I want to give to you, so that participants like you, you can improve your research. So first of all, I want to give a basic input to you, basic knowledge about sky square test, where or how, what way you want to apply. So in that, I want to take some 5 to 10 minutes stating the data and variables. Unless otherwise you know about the data and the variables, you cannot, you never do a proper research by using the sky square test. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to give 5 to 10 minutes regarding about this data and variable. In that, first one is the scales. See, in the human beings, we are using different scales. What are they? Meter ho gaya, weight ho gaya, and the length ho gaya, centimeter and the kilogram and so on, to measure various quantities. In the same way, what is a scale? Scale is a tool or mechanism to the differentiating between one to other categories. That is the nothing but scale. In human, we are using to measure the length. Meter is to measure the length. Kilogram to measure the weight. If you want to measure your weight, you cannot go for length. You must measure, go for weight. And you are measuring the volume with the help of liter. The same way, ladies and gentlemen, in your research, your variables are classified under different category, different scale. What are the different types of scale that I want to give? That is measurement of area in types of scales. That is one, you see, nominal scale. How we have a meter length, weight and so on in the human life are measuring this weight and length and so on. Same way in research, you have a nominal scale and ordinal scale, interval scale. Then last one is called the ratio scale. These all scales, sometimes some researcher may come to know. I know very well, but not up to the standard. I will give the standard of knowing what level you want to know. Yes, what is a nominal scale? Let us go for this nominal level measurement. In nominal level measurement, a variable is measured with the categorical variable. And these variables are very rough and tough. Very rough and tough. Some people may be very soft. Some people may be very hard, rough and tough. The same way, out of the four variables, the nominal variables are very rough and tough, where you cannot do a sophisticated data analysis. Gentlemen, you cannot do a sophisticated data analysis with the help of nominal data. Why so? Because it is very rough and tough. Let us see what is the, how it is rough and tough. I cannot say in words rough and tough. I must demonstrate how it is rough and tough. You can see nominal scale is one that allows the researcher to assign the subject certain categories or groups. Certain categories or groups. What are the categories? You see, for example, gender. Gender is a variable where you are categorized. Tuck, tuck, tuck. What is the tuck, tuck, tuck? That is male, female, or anything else. So gender is a variable. And the male and the females are attributes. Please listen. These are the words you never heard about in your research. What? Attributes. A variable which has a two attributes. A variable may have a three attributes. A variable may have a 4, 5, 6 attributes. That is depends upon the researcher how he is going to frame the question in the demographic variable. Right? So here you see gender is in a variable. I am categorized into two categories. That is, gender is a tree where you have a two branches alone. One is a male, another one is a female. Some other tree may have a three branches also, that is called tree attributes. Some tree may have a 5, 6 and so on. Ladies and gentlemen, I am going to give some demonstration application. Listen. See, here is a gender is a variable and its attributes are male and female. Do not forget that word. Attributes, male and female. Exercise for you. That is for you by understanding the first one which I explained. Gender is the variable and the attributes are male and female. You identify the variable and the attributes. Ladies and gentlemen, married, single, marital status, and widow. Out of these three, which is the variable? You please identify. Every mind should go and should be active. And but you don't want to give your presentation, your answer. But everyone should think it of. Think it of. What is the variable? Marital status. What are the attributes here, ladies and gentlemen? Married, single, widow. Here you can see there is no order of, there is no order in the nominal variable. You put this bloody married first one, otherwise you put it in the last one. Who is going to ask the, you know, ask the question to you? No. Even if you take, for example, in gender, you put male first or second female. Otherwise, you take this bloody female first and put in the male in the second. Nothing wrong. There is no order at all. That is why these variables are called very rough and tough, which we cannot go for sophisticated data analysis. So listen, here you can go for married, single, widow, otherwise widow, single, widow, or single, married, like that. You can go for any way of classification you can go for. There is no order at all. Where? In nominal variable. Some variable will have an order that I will tell you later. So that is why I am very particular about order. The nominal variable never be have a order. Please. Next. You see. Continuation. Identify the variable and the attributes. See. Low income, middle income, status of the people, high income. Status of the people is the variable and their attributes are low income, middle income, and the high income. See, so this is a way you must identify the variable and the attribute whenever you are going to plan a questionnaire under the head demographic variable. Next, identify the variable and the attributes here. Hindu, Muslim, religion, Christian. What is the variable? Name of the variable? Religion. Under which you have a Hindu, Muslim, Christian. Is there any order? No. Whether may be a first Christian, second may be Muslim, third may be Hindu, otherwise first Hindu, Muslim, Christian. Whatever may be the order, you can put it. No problem. No problem. So there is no order. That is why it is a very rough and tough. Next. You can see this next one. Another one is called ordinal data. Second, I think you are very particular about what is a nominal data. Now we have going for ordinal data. See, ordinal. Order plus null. Ordinal. Ordinal. Here, we have some order. In the first one, we don't have an order. Anywhere you can arrange it. No one will ask you. If you put any type of order, the analysis does not have any impact. But in ordinal, we have a order. What is order? Hey, first person. Hey, you stand on the first one. This is the second one. Third, fourth. Likewise, we have a order. That is why first place, second place, third place, and so on. That is why it is called ordinal. So it is also a category. What? The ordinal data is also a category group only, but it have a order. You see the difference. But this ordinal variables are something good, something better than what? Nominal variable. Something. How it is something is better? Because it is ordered. Okay. Yes. See? Ordinal scale. That is why I want to give some ordinal exercise on ordinal variable. Identify the variable and show the order here. Instead of attributes, I have given order. That is very important one. Because there I have given attributes. The attributes can be fixed, can be arranged in any form, any conditions. But here there is no order. There is no condition. But here we have an order. Identify the variable. Here, what is a variable? Career opportunity. Under which, what is the order? Okay, that is one. Moderate, good, excellent. Otherwise, excellent, good, moderate. Okay, so there must be some order. Next one, identify the variable and show the order. Investment climate, bad, fair, good, very good. So there must be some order is there. Next, identify the variable and show the order. What is the variable? Merit. Merit of the students. What is the merit of the students? A grade, B grade, C grade, D grade. Otherwise, you take in reverse. D grade, C grade, B grade, A grade, and so on. So there must be some order is there. Okay. Next. Right. Here you see the international... An international businessman wants to see the performance of the company categorized into low profit making, break-even point, and profit-making companies of a firm depends upon which the country is categorized low-earning country, middle-earning country, and high-earning country. It is located. What is the IV and its attributes? IV. What is IV? IV is not a medical term. IV is nothing but independent variable, ladies and gentlemen. What is the independent variable here? Here. What is the dependent variable and its attributes? Just you have to see. Before going to ask the question, what is the IV and the DV? Let me explain about what is the IV and DV. Independent variable is nothing but a variable which can influence the other variable. Other variable. You take, for example, myself is sitting in one place and participants are all sitting in throughout India, otherwise throughout the world. So there are two variables, one resource person and the participants. Here, what is the resource person? What is the participants? The resource person is the influencing these all participants who are listening this lecture throughout the world. Throughout the world. So the resource person is the independent variable, influencing variable. How far I am going to influence? How your knowledge is going to improve or disimprove? You see? Improve or disimprove. That is the influencing variable on participant. So here the participants are dependent variable. So here the same way here, how these variable and there are two variables are there. What are companies and countries? Companies with the profit making company or loss making company. Countries where these profit-making company, loss-making companies. So here, what is the independent variable? See, Country is the independent variable which influence the profit, not company, profit making company which influence the country. See, listen, this is a very important one. As a researcher, you should know about what is the IV and the DV. So country is the independent variable. What are the attributes? Low, middle, and high earning companies. Next, what is a dependent variable? You know very well. There are two variables. One is no. What is other? Other is called what? The country. See, companies, attributes, loss, break-even point, or profit-making country, profit-making companies. So there are two variables, IV, independent variable, and dependent variable. Independent variable is nothing but influence variable, and influenced variable is the DV variable. That is the thing which you must know. Even there are many people who have asked or have some doubts in the last two sessions. That is why I have given separately for this one. Next one. A researcher wants to determine if the satisfaction level of the employee. Everybody is going in this tech park. As soon as they are entering into the tech park, they want to go for Canada, America, or Asia, or other places. So we want to know about the level of satisfaction. There are some people, they want to be remain in India itself. So the level of satisfaction depends upon what? The placement, local or international. Okay, what is the influencing variable here? What is the independent variable? What is the influencing variable? You can see the influencing variable, placement area. This is a IV. This is a independent variable, placement area. What are the attributes? Local or international. Dependent variable, level of satisfaction, low, middle, high. So this is the way you must categorize it into IV and DV in the case of nominal variable. You must be very clear, right? So this all very important one where we are going to do some analysis. Next one, this ordinal data, meaningless, right. What is the characteristics of this ordinal and nominal data? See, in nominal data, I have seen some of the researchers in the research project. For nominal data, they are calculating mean, median, mode, standard deviation, all these things. This is very improper way where you are preparing for nominal data. You are not supposed to calculate mean value, median value, or mode value. If you calculate, you may be asked to go back to your PG and read well. So you are not supposed to calculate mean, median, mode for nominal data, even when you are sleeping in your bed. Hey, Baba, can you calculate this mean, median, mode for nominal data? You should say, no, sir. You never say yes. If you say yes, you will be detained for another 2-3 years in the same research field. So meaningless for doing that descriptive statistics. You are not supposed to calculate for descriptive statistics for nominal and ordinal data. For ordinal data, you can go for median. Median, no mean value, right? Next. It is also known as a discrete data. This nominal and ordinal data is also called what? Discrete data. See, sir, you said that you cannot go for mean, median, mode, standard deviation, all these things. Then what else I can do it? Yes, you can do it all. What a histogram, this and that. But in the first 25 pages or 30 pages, you may go for all colorful picture, that you can do it. That is usually happen in India, but that is also a wrong notion in Indian research. That is why our Indian research is not at par with the international level, that I will tell you later why all these things. only summary statistics such as a frequency and the percentage can be done with the help of what variable? Nominal and ordinal. You can go for only frequency and percentage, not anything else. Next, for you are not supposed to calculate mean value. This is a 1000 watts danger, 1000 watts current. Just you can imagine if you put your own finger in 1000 watt, what will happen? The same way. The ordinal data that is equivalent to putting your finger on 1000 watts currents. Okay, next one. For inferential analysis, sir, okay, with the help of these all data, ordinal and nominal data, can I go for only frequency? Can't you go for any inferential data analysis? Yes. What is the inferential data? That is the non-parametric test only you can do it. You cannot touch on parametric test with the help of nominal variable and the ordinal variable. Please make your mind clear. So in extreme level, you can do econometrics. With the help of this data, I have attended econometrics to my research scholar and asked to go and to present in the IIT and IIM, only because the IIT and IIMs are more interested to see the research by using the econometrics. So with the help of this demographic variable, other people will go for showing some diagram, picture, bio chart or bar chart. No. In Asian, in developed countries, with the help of demographic variable, they are going for doing econometrics. Why not our people? So please explore the knowledge. So these are the some basic characteristics. Then next, coming to this, so see, my data, my chi-square test is depends only on nominal and ordinal. Please make your mind clear. With the help of interval and scale, I cannot, I never, if I do it, I am not fit for a resource person. I am useless bugger for doing the resource person. So the chi-square test can be possible, ladies and gentlemen, only with the help of nominal and ordinal. How the nominal and ordinal? A variable must have and it's there some attributes. A variable must have and there some order. The odd attributes are some order. Only with the help of this variable alone, you can go for chi-square test. Your mind should be very clear. Even after this PowerPoint, whenever I'm going to do it, only with the help of this type of variable, I will do the chi-square test. With the help of interval and the ratio, I cannot do the chi-square test. It is very bad if you do it. I am very sorry. You are not fit for doing the research if you take an interval and ratio for doing the chi-square test. But however, I want to tell you what is meant by interval data and ratio data. So I am taking so much of time. Whether I am going to complete, please. Forgive me, you please go up to 6 o'clock. Let me, whatever the thing, I will complete 6 o'clock. Next, interval. See, the gap between one interval must be equal to other interval. You take, for example, you may be a 40 years old. You take the difference from 10th year to 20th year is equivalent to 30 to 40 years. Do you have that? There must be some differentiation. Maybe 1 or 2 days, maybe a difference due to leave or all these things. Nonsense. So otherwise, it should be a very equal. Just so you can imagine your father and the son age, whether the father and the son age will be varies when the time passes. No. So interval, that is the interval. You see, characteristics of nominal and ordinal scale plus concept of equality of interval. In addition to this nominal and ordinal, we are taking this, the concept of equal intervals. Equal distance exists between the number, that is called what? Interval data. But the origin could not be identified. It is only an arbitrary origin. We do not know. origin we do not know. Only the equal interval will be equal. But what is the starting point? I am very sorry, sir. So, but that in addition to this nominal, ordinal, the interval data will have an interval. That is, since the interval data doesn't have an arbitrary, I mean zero point, we are going for some other variable which is called ratio, which has a starting point at this zero. Okay, so that out of these four variables, ratio is the best variable which you can use it for any sophisticated analysis, parametric test, and the results which you are getting is very powerful, very powerful. Even it may be more than 1000 watts. Okay, right. So the ratio is 0.0, that already I have said to you. Let me explain. This current you have studied, all you are belongs to maximum number of parties, maybe coming from this commerce background. The current ratio equal to 2. Current ratio is equal to 2. What do you understand by current ratio? Current assets by current liability. Current ratio 2 means what? Current liability is equal to 1. For every 1 rupee of current liability, the company is having 2 rupees of current assets. So you see how much of interpretation you are going to do. For every 1 rupee of current liability, the company is having the current assets worth rupees 2. In case the current liability is 1 lakh, what is the current assets? 2 lakh. What is the working capital? 2 lakhs minus 1 lakh is equal to 1 lakh is equal to working capital. That way you can go for inferencing the current, ratios. So that is why it is more sophisticated. Working capital is 1 lakh. What is the current liability? That all I have said already. Exercise on ratio variables, height, weight, age, length, degree Kelvin, degrees of Celsius, all you can go for this ratio variable. Now, I'm putting this some questions in front of you. What is your age? What is your age? Hello? In India, just I want to give, but it will take some time. Maximum number of peoples, 95. Why 95? 99% of the research caller, they are asking the demographic variable, what is your age? They are giving block up to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 50, 50 to 100, and so on. What is that the name or nature of the variable? Nominal. If you give up to 20, 20 to 30, 40 to 50, like that, if you give, that is called a nominal variable. This nominal variable can also be called as close-ended variable. What is a close-ended variable? Hey, participant, make your mind clear. What I am asking? I am asking only 4 categories. You tick any one among the 4. You are not supposed to give anything more than 4 or less than 4. If it is more than 4 or less than 4, this variable, I am missing figure. It's a missing figure. So, what is your A? So, my humble request, the researcher in India, they are asking only as a nominal variable, what is your age? What is your income? They are asking as a categorical variable. Income up to 40,000, 40 to 50, 50 to 1 lakh, 1 lakh to 2 lakh, 2 lakh to 5 lakh. This is the way our own Indian researchers are doing. This is wrong. That is why our Indian researchers are not improving at par with the developed countries. If you go for these developed countries, they never ask the age or income. They usually go for open-ended data, maximum what extent it is possible, they will go for open-ended data. My ladies and gentlemen, you are also after listening this PDP from Petition College of Arts and Science, Madras. Whenever you are framing the questionnaire under the head demographic variable, do not give category. Do not category. If you are going for category, you are not doing this research for the interest of you as well as for this Indian nation. You are going to do the research for the interest of getting this stipend, increment for promotions only. That is why even out of 200 university or 500 university, none of the university is coming under the world rank. World rank. Why? What is your range? Giving category. Oh, income category. No, you are wrong. You give open-ended data. Open-ended data. Maximum, the research scholar should go for open-ended data under the part A, demographic variable. Even education, our people ask, hey, what is your education? Plus two, degree, PhD, and so on. No, it is very bad. That is why in India, the research has not improved. It is not competitive with the other countries, developed countries. Go for open-ended data. Open-ended data. Why so? Because if you have a closed-ended data and this closed-ended data cannot be converted into open-ended data. Whereas if you have a open-ended data and this can be converted into closed-ended data if you want. Then you may ask bloody Shanmugasundaram, what is the necessity if you want to go for open-ended data? Yes. I will tell you, this is a very important stage. This is the very important place where you want to concentrate. Why you should go for this open-ended data? This open-ended data can be used in many cases with the help of controlled variable. If you go for ANOVA family, many of the researchers know only one way ANOVA. I am very sorry, research scholar. In ANOVA family, you have a one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA, three-way ANOVA, factorial ANOVA, repeated measures may ANOVA, two-way repeated measure ANOVA, three-way repeated measure ANOVA, four-way repeated measure ANOVA, ANOVA, factorial ANOVA. Then if you come under the MANOVA, one-way MANOVA, factorial MANOVA, MANOVA, the COVA, ANOVA, MANOVA, what is a COVA? Covariate. For that purpose, covariate analysis, you want some variable. That variable must be a scale variable. For that, you can use the what is your age if you collect the data as an open-ended. If you collect your income as an open-ended, that income can be taken as a covariate there. If you take advertisement, otherwise if you take education as an open-ended, that can be taken as a covariate. Because our people never touch on this. So what is the covariate, sir? We know only ANOVA, sir, to complete my PhD so that next step I will go for getting the remuneration and go for promotion. Why all bloody nonsense you are telling to go for covariate this and that? No, this is not the way. You please try to improve your knowledge in research. Not because of getting the degree, PhD degree. Not because of getting this stipend or some one increment or two increment. Not because of getting this promotion, you start. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I started my career as a postgraduate teacher in 1980. I end my career in 2010 as a professor in the Central University because of this hard work throughout my bloody life. So you please work for the improvement of your own knowledge, the rewards like remuneration, otherwise your promotion will come automatically, automatically. So my humble request, hereafter, do not go for what is your age, closed ended, nine, what the hell? What is your income, closed ended, nine. What is, then what is your education, closed ended, nine. Go for open ended. Go for open-ended. So this way I'm wasting my time, I think, because if I spend more time, I cannot go for this next one. Here, what is your What is your age? What is, if you ask this variable, it is a open-ended. Open-ended means anyone can give any value. That is why it is called a open-ended. This is called a scale variable. What is your income? My income is 995 rupees 50 paise, sir. Another person, 10,000, sir. Another person, 25,000. Likewise, they are giving their own. Finally, there are 100 number of frequencies, 200. Each and every person will have their own frequency value. That is why it is called open-ended. Open-ended. So that is why it is called scale variable. Scale variable. Next, how much the advertisement expenditure? Scale variable. What is your marriage? How is your marriage life, sir? Dull, sir. Okay, sir. Happy, sir. Very happy, sir. That is nominal. Otherwise, ordinal. Ordinal data. Okay, next one. What is the Indian GDP in the last 20 years? Scale variable. Are you satisfied with my session? Are you happy with my session? Poor. Very poor. Okay, sir. Ordinal. Ordinal. We are giving some order. Order. What is your hair color? What is your hair color? Black, sir. Brown, sir. White, sir. So, this order may be interchanged. Nominal. Nominal variable. So, this is the way research scholar should identify nominal, ordinal, interval, and the ratios. Okay? Right. That's all regarding which I want to give some basic information before going to start my the exact syllabus on Skyscraper test. So, though I have said four types of variable, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio, you please forget about the interval and the ratio. You please listen about the nominal and the ordinal. Only these variable alone can be used for the Skyscraper test. So already I said Skyscraper test is a common noun wherein the proper nouns are called goodness of faith, association for independence. Third one is homogeneity. So ladies and gentlemen, research scholar, please mention in the research methodology the proper Skyscraper test, proper noun of the Skyscraper test. Do not say Skyscraper test. By saying Skyscraper test, whether he himself or herself may not know whether he has applied goodness of faith or association or a homogeneity. That is why he don't want to disclose the real. Okay, that is wrong. So hereafter, by attending this seminar, this session, third session, you must be very particular about writing in Skyscraper test, I applied goodness of faith. In Skyscraper test, I applied test for association, otherwise independent. In Skyscraper test, I applied for homogeneity. What for all this nonsense? I will tell you one by one. First, we are going for this session in the half an hour. I should have completed this goodness of fit. I do not know still how many minutes is there for half an hour. Skyscraper test for goodness of fit. This test is based on only one categorical variable. Only one categorical variable. No more category, only one category. You sometimes, a single tree, can you possibly a single tree become a garden? No, two, three. The same way some researcher will ask, hey, how can it possible to do a analysis with the help of one single tree? Yeah? No, it is not possible. No, don't say. That's why I'm giving. With the help of one categorical variable, you can do a test. That is why it is called Skyscraper test of goodness of fit with the help of nominal variable. Here you see what is your requirements? Only one categorical variable. Example, what is your choice of smart mode? Smart mode. What's your choice? You are going to study some marketing survey, maybe at Chennai or maybe at Bangalore or any metropolitan cities. What is the choice of, because as you are a retailer, which smartphone do you want to display in the retail shops? You want to calculate, you want to identify, you want to do some research because you are done a PhD. After doing the PhD, you want to do, and you become an agent of some particular people or business. You can do it, a business you can do. So what is your choice of smartphone you want to do in Madras or city, your own population you are taking in Madras? You are going to start a retail shops, smartphone, which smartphone you must be very particular. So unless otherwise, you know that people mental in what type of smartphone they are interested, you cannot concentrate. So therefore, you are going to, this is only one question that become only one variable. One variable. What are the attributes are there? What are the smartphone? Samsung, HTC, Apple, any other. Four attributes are there. Whether you have any order here? No order at all. So that becomes your nominal variable. Okay? Right, one sample. So for that, what type of test which you can apply? One sample size. That is why it is the name itself, one sample skyscraper test. Goodness of fit test. Even goodness of fit test, otherwise one sample skyscraper test. Both are same only. You can apply this name or that name. No, no problem. Skyscraper test for one sample skyscraper. Even if you do one sample skyscraper, that itself indicates goodness of fit test. Okay. What it says, it compares. In all the three tests, fit, association, homogeneity, it compare observed value and expected value. That's all. In all the three cases, it compare observed value and expected value, and it will give the results. Okay, right. Then, what is the difference between binomial and one sample skyscraper test? One sample, you have only one category. Binomial, you have a two variables, and each variable will have a two attributes. You see, binomial, one sample skyscraper test may have a any attributes. As we have seen already, here in the smartphone, we have a four. Why not five? You can take six also. Even you take a two also, nothing wrong. But don't ask me, sir, can you take only one, sir? With the help of one, what you are going to do? Don't ask this type of silly questions. Don't post it like that, this type of silly question in these sessions. Okay, so minimum you want. So then only you can compare to maximum. Okay, so for skyscraper goodness of weight, you have only one variable, but attributes may be anywhere. But case of binomial, a variable which have only the two category. So two variable, each should have a two category. That is why it is called binomial. The difference between binomial and one sample skyscraper test. Next, case study for skyscraper test for goodness of fit. Just I have taken some case study. A research scholar wants to do a research. Brand preference. That already we have seen. Which brand of smartphone you are interested? So what is the topic you can give for this above case study? Customer brand preference on smartphones. Customer brand preference on smartphones. What is your research question? See, in research, you must follow certain rules, certain system. What is the system? First research question, followed by research, or even before research question, statement of the problem. Statement of the problem, next research question. Research question, next objectives. Next to the objectives, hypothesis. Next to the hypothesis, selection of variable. Next, name of the test which you are going to apply. What is the significance level? What is the confidence level? And the accept and reject criteria. So this is the format which you want to apply. This is the format which you should apply. So accordingly, I have given a model. So the topic is customer brand preference on smartphones. What is your research question connected with your about topic? Do smartphone brand Samsung, HTC, Apple, and others are having same attractive to the customer at Bangalore city? I am taking this one population. The population is the Bangalore. Population is the Bangalore. It may be some 1 crore or 50 lakhs and so on. That becomes the population. What is your objectives on the basis of your research question as given above? to study the level of attractiveness of smartphone brands at Bangalore city. So this is the objectives. So topic, questions, objectives, followed by hypothesis. What is hypothesis? Smartphone brand, Samsung, this and this are equally attractive to the customer at Bangalore city. That is why it is called null hypothesis. Null hypothesis is nothing but a nil hypothesis. Nil means what? There is no difference. So that is why which we are given. What is a research hypothesis? Alternative hypothesis, also called research hypothesis, are not equally attractive. So there is a difference. So I want to find out. Okay. What is your variable on the base of your hypothesis? One variable, brand preference, with four attributes. On the other variable expected to calculate this, what is software? Which software will take? Because it is only one variable. The other variable will be taken by the software itself. You need not worry about that. The name of the test is Sky Square test for goodness of fit. Why you are Sky Square test? Because it's only one variable. Significance level is 5%. The sample size is much smaller. This is assumption. Much smaller than the populations. Every cell must have a minimum of 5. All the respondents must be given independently. What is independent? In many cases, you must have known independent. Independent is nothing but some people in your school, in your colleges, they are, hey, what is the questionnaire? Yeah, you please do it and give it to me. I will strike all this pretty nonsense as you have done it. It is not independent. So these two questionnaires become considered as one. So that is the independent. Independent means the individual respondent must disclose his own interest in the research. That is called independent. Okay, are you clear? So the expected frequency less than well. These are some assumptions. What is the guideline for accepting? 5%. In social science, we can take confidence level is 95%. Significance level is 5%. See, I attended one public viva of PhD. And they are given like that only. Sir, confidence level 95%, significance level 5%. I asked the researcher, why not 6% and why not 4%? Why you are very particular about 5%? Tell me. I asked the questions. See, this is my question which I am putting in front of all the research scholar. You find out and try find out this answer during your research course. But do not post this type of question again to me. Okay. These are some thought-provoking questions which I am putting before you. I ask these questions. The research scholar said, what they said, I have gone for nearly 200 review of literature, sir. All the review of literature, they are given only 5%, p-value 90%. That is why I also 201. As a person, I can also put, I am carry out my research only this. This is the answer which I got it from the students who is doing this presentation in the Viva. Is it correct or wrong? If it is wrong, what is the correct? You please explore the knowledge. Do not post the question again to me. Like next one. So these are all discussions. Okay. So AP style, with the help of this is the way which you want to write. AP style, American Psychological Association has given here some method. If you want to send your research article to these American articles, then you have to follow certain methods. Accordingly, only you have to prepare. So what is that system? With the help of 5% significance level, conducted the Sky Square test of goodness of fit test to see the smartphone brands preference among Samsung, HTC, Apple, and so on. But they are equally attracted by the customer in Bangalore city based on p-value is greater than 0.05. Sky Square value this much and degree of freedom is this much, only this. only you have to give this answer. That's all. Okay, right. See, what I want to give more than I said in the first itself, I want to give more information about the skyscraper to the participant. That is why I selected the skyscraper. Though I am familiar about all these tests, T-test, ANOVA family, factor analysis, SMART and SEM, this and that, all this, I am very particular about. Why? See, our research scholars are very particular about significant. If you have got significant, your research is over. If you take it to the significant value to your guide or supervisor, and he is also a satisfied person because he may not know beyond that level. So as a researcher, see, in developed countries, they never stop their research up to significant. They will go for beyond significant. What is this beyond significant? I conduct a 7 days workshop in offline, not online, 7 days workshop. The theme of the workshop is what is beyond significance. That will give the quality of research. Whether you want to do a quantity research or quality of research, you must have both quantity as well as quality of research. But our people never touch on that part, the quality of research. I want to teach you the quality of the research. I want to teach the quality, how to improve the quality of research in skyscraper test. In skyscraper test, I mean goodness of weight, association, and homogeneity. I want to improve the quality of the research. If you send in any article to these developed countries, Europe or America, they will see mainly this one. What is this one? The effect size. That effect size which gives the quality of research. If you are not giving this effect size, no quality. You are not considering, you are simply showing only quantity. I received a project, PhD project, nearly 400 pages. See, 200 pages I have seen only ANOVA. I have given 4-page evaluation stating, and this 200 cut, make it only 10 pages. 10 pages, that can be easily possible. Research scholars are feeling, if you give more pages, that will have more weightage. Yes, of course, it will have more weightage only in the postal, not to the examiner. Please listen. Please learn. So your research should be quality oriented. How do you improve the quality oriented? Let me explain here. See, one marathon race, which I'm going to do it, marathon, myself and Prashuddha Man, who is one of the coordinators in the Vedishan College of Arts and Science, I'm going for marathon, I am the old person. Prashuddha Man is a very young and energetic. Both were running in the marathon. See, finally, Prashuddha Man has become the first one. I am behind of him, nearly 5 meters or 6 meters. So both significant. Significant. Here also significant. Here also significant. Please listen. Another one day, another situation. Myself, Mr. Durayarasan also is going for marathon running. See, the Durayarasan is again become first, but I am far behind, nearly 1 kilometer away. But in both the tests, which gives what? Significant. Hello. Please listen. Both the tests which gives significant. Our research scholar will stop our research significant. That's all. But you see the first test, the significant difference between Shanmuga, the bloody Shanmuga Sundaram and Purushottaman is 5 meter only. But in second test, the bloody Shanmuga Sundaram and the Durayarasan, the distance covered, the Durayarasan is 1 kilometer away. He's a first guide, 1 kilometer. I'm 1 kilometer behind. That also shows significance, but finally both are significant. You want to give significance, sir. My research is okay, sir. You complete, sir, you sign, sir, I will submit my research and for going for the evaluation. Who is the evaluator? He may also not know really all this, you know, quality of research. He also very much interested only the quantity of research, how many pages he may weigh the project, whether it have a 2 kg or 3 kg, okay, good, bad, very good, commendation on this and that. So here, you as a researcher, you must show it, the quality of research, whether the significant difference is the lower level or middle level or higher level, so that your research will be very helpful to the policy maker to take urgent steps. Slowly you can take, otherwise this difference is always there. Yeah, you leave it there, we will see. So that way, that would be very helpful. So that quality of research is basically necessary or essential. So that part I am going to teach you, ladies and gentlemen, here, this effect size. That's why I given this effect size, okay? Effect size, Cohen suggested that 0.2 is a small, 0.5 is a middle, 0.8 is a higher income people. So for identifying this quality of research, effect size, use pile test for goodness of fit and binomial variable, that is 2 into 2. Other than goodness of fit by 2 by 2, use Gramer B test and all, I will tell you that. Okay, so this is a example, Gramer B2, how do you calculate all these things which I have given, which you need, I have given the concept how to arrive, but you need not calculate, everything will be supported by the SPSS output. You can easily arrive the answer, but only you want to do the writing. That's all. Okay, so that's all which I want to share. Now I will go for, you know, this what you called data for this practical aspects. Okay, share. Now I want to go for back. Durayarasan, can you help me how to go for back for this?
Yes, sir. Now you can open the SPSS software, sir.
How do you go?
Maybe you can minimize this one, sir. You can minimize this one.
Minimize how to meet. Very poor in the tech.
No problem, sir.
How to minimize the bar?
In the top corner, there is a symbol, sir. In the minus symbol, you can minimize. Maybe you can give it the escape, sir. Escape. In your system, there is a escape, sir. Escape. No. Sir, in your laptop. Oh, yeah, that's, yes, sir. Now you can minimize. You can minimize.
Thank you. Yes, now I'm going to take the data file. In the data file, I'm going to take one sample chi-square test. In one sample chi-square test, I will take one, then I will take this consolidated data. Okay. Right. The time is 5. Oh my God. 1 hour. Oh, yeah. So, I'm very sorry. Oh my God. Okay. You see, this is a brand. You see here, you see. Can you see this SPSS data pile? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Which brand of smartphone do you prefer? That is one I'm going to take. One for Samsung, 2 for HTC, Apple, 2, 3 for Apple, 4 for others. Okay, so this is the way, this is the concept which I explained already. I have taken only this one only. Okay, then if you take this data is have this first one is ID, which you don't want to take it. You have to take only the brand. Okay, now I will go for I cannot have this. Okay, I will see. Yes. Okay, now I will go for analysis. I'll go for analysis, go for non-parametric test. So if it is a one sample chi-square test, that is goodness of fit, you have to go for non-parametric test, legacy dialogue back, there you can find chi-square test. Hey, Come on. What has happened? Ah, Sky Circus. So take the only the brand of smartphone. Only one variable alone in the dialog box. That is a test variable list. In the test variable list, you have to take only the one variable. You are not supposed. Why? So because it is a one sample. So in one sample, you cannot push these 2-3 variable. Okay. So next, you can see all categories are equal. All categories. You can give this. Okay. I will come into this next aspect. Next. Okay. Here you see the Samsung observed 14, expected 10.8. How do you get this 10.8? It's very simple. 43 divided by 4, it becomes 10.8 expected. This total sample divided by the 4 smartphone divided by 4, it becomes 10.8. This is expected. And 14 minus 10.8, it becomes what you call 3.3 is a residual. Residual. The residual is maybe a plus or minus. What is a plus? Say if the observed frequency is more than the expected plus. Say if the observed is lesser than the expected minus. That's all. So by taking this residual and this sexual test will be calculated. This is what you called what is a significant value 0.073. That is nothing but 7.3%. The degree of freedom is 3. What is the degree of freedom? 3. Because I have taken 4 smartphone. 1 minus 4 minus 1 is equal to 3 is the degree of freedom. What is the sky square value? That is 6.953 and so on. So here, what is your decision criteria? Sir, with the help of p-value 5%, I conducted one sample sky square test for goodness of fit to see the is there any differences in the smartphone preference in the Bangalore city? The p-value is equal to 0.073, comma, degree of freedom is 3, and the sky square value is this much. It accept the null hypothesis. That indicates there is no difference in the smartphone who are preference in the Bangalore city. This is the way which you want to give some 3-4 lines. That's all. See, you should not give all this table, this and that. Not necessary. It will occupy maximum place. That's all over. Next, I will take one more example in other form. In other form, I will take it on snow. I will give no. Okay, that I will go for minimize. Then I will take another one data. You see this other data. This is other type of data. There is a one sample consolidated data. See, the first one which I have given is a individual data. What is the individual data? I will tell you. Hello, one sample. What is the individual data? This is a consolidated data. Okay, after explaining this one, I will go for this. This is a consolidated data. You see the first one and the second one, you see. Okay. What happened? One sample, this. You see, this is the individual data. You see here, individual data, which you can see here. It is going up to collection of this individual data. But this individual data is consolidated. I have put it into the form of a two variable only. That is a smartphone preference. Samsung, HTC, Apple, others. This number is a frequency, interested person. That's all. So in that case, how do you calculate? This is a different form. So one sample sky square test can be do it in two ways. One in the form of individual test, another is in the form of consolidated data. First one I have said individual data. This is for consolidated data. How do you calculate consolidated data? Hello, ladies and gentlemen, you can go for in this data set, weight cases, take this number smartphone, number, use frequencies. You click weight cases by apply. Okay. Okay. Right. Next. Next, you can go for analyze. That is non-parametric test. Legacy dialog box. One square test. Smartphone ID. Smartphone. This is a frequency number which already we have taken. See here. We have taken only these things. The same answer you will get. The same answer. So one is individual data, another one is a consolidated data. If you have a consolidated data, you have to go for data center. You have to go for data center. Go to the weight cases. In weight cases, take the frequency by clicking here and OK. Then you can go to this analysis. You can go to the analysis. Non-parametric test. Hey, come on. Hey. Non-parametric test, legacy dialog box, go to the sky square test. Here you can take only the smart portfolio. Then you will be getting. Okay, right. This is one way. Another one, you can see here, all categories are equal. The expected value which is taken by the system are equal. That means 43 response are divided into 4. But if you are very particular about any value, you can give the value here. You can give the value here. What is the value? There are 4 category. You can give some 30%. First one is what you called it? 30. First one, value 30%. 30% add. Another one is 20. Another one is a 20 add. Third one is again some 40. Okay, add. Then the last one is a. But if you add all the 4, that should be a 100. Otherwise, you should be at 10. It should be at 10. 100. That is a 100%. If you add all these 4 categories, you should have a 100 or 1. You can give a decimal also, no problem. So if you show it like that, the expected value will be calculated on the basis of this value. You adjust, you can see the answer. Come on. Come on, you see the expected values are varies. Here you see, the expected value. Previous data, you may have a 10.8, and so on. But here it is a varies because we are assigned the value. So this way you can do it in the one sample size. That's all which I want to give. Time is over. So now you please post your questions. Then I will try to answer for the question. Mr. Durairarasan, please come on.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your session, sir. First session.
Now I want to go for this. You know, how to go for this? Just. Yes. Okay. Right. Okay. Pa. Yes, you can start the question.
Yes. Thank you, sir. The first question from Vicky.
Yes.
The first question from Vicky. The independent variable which we can vary or manipulate.
An independent variable
which we can vary or manipulate.
It will manipulate. Why? It can manipulate that dependent variable.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Archana.
How
to identify variables in your research?
Very good. How do you identify the variable in the research? Right. First, you go to this topic. What is the problem? And the problem will be made to the research question. The research question will be converted into different objectives. In different objectives, formulate hypothesis. For each and every hypothesis, you know what are the variable. That variable, you please make it in the form of a questionnaire. Next question.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Ramalakshmi. Which technique is best to test the hypothesis, chi-square test or ANOVA?
Oh, your question is wrong. You are asking wrong question. Again, testing hypothesis, chi-square, ANOVA. See, you have a meter line and a broad gauge line, right? You have a railway line, meter gauge and a broad gauge. There are two lines are there. Yeah, meter gauge engine cannot run in the broad gauge. Yeah, broad gauge train cannot run in the meter gauge. So, ladies, the research scholar asked a meter gauge question in the broad gauge question asked in the, because the chi square test is based on nominal data, ANOVA is based on the scale data. So, don't interchange. So, your question is 100% wrong. You please explore. Okay, next.
Thank you, sir. So, the next question from Anjana Verma. People do not give answer the open-ended questions.
Open-ended. So questions. If they are giving, if they are not giving open-ended, will they give the close-ended? Because there is a question. Their question is there. See, you ask what is your age, let them give even some question. Even if they are some, even if you are a girl, he said 40 years, let them give 30, nothing wrong. But I want only the open-ended data. Do not ask this type of question to me. Do you think that even if you give for closed-ended data, are they giving the good? If you are a good respondent, they will give you the good information. If they are, I mean, you are going for wrong person, that is why they are giving a wrong information. So do not go for such a person. So these are not silly questions which you don't give me. Sir, they, if you go for open-ended, sir, they will not never give this. It is not the correct way. Okay, you always go for open-ended data. That is a good for you are doing the research. That's all. Next.
So the next question, if we collect database open-ended question, how do we run the descriptive statistics and the inference in SPSS?
See, for nominal data, you are not go for any inferential data. That inferential data, why I am going for this open-ended data, this can be taken in two form. One, you can take it as a closed-ended data. You can convert with the help of the SPSS itself, you can convert the open-ended data into closed-ended data. That is one. Number two, the same data can be used for high data analysis. As already I have said, ANOVA, MANOVA, by using the covariate. So if you are so interested to use the sophisticated and you will be getting the accuracy or very precision answer, you can use it. So if you go for open-ended, it will be converted into closed-ended data that can be used for demography variable as usual. As it is, if you have your open-ended data that can be used as a covariate, that will be very helpful for your data analysis. That is why I am asking. But if you collect as it is closed-ended, that cannot be converted into open-ended and cannot be used for this covariates. Next.
Thank you, sir. The next question from Milan. Is it necessary to apply data reliability test before test?
Hello. This is a question which always asking even the first session, second session, third session. Pretty Shanmugasundara useless for giving the answer for that. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, research scholar, reliability test is based on the mean value and the standard deviation. Reliability test is based on the mean value and the standard deviation. Where is the mean value and the standard deviation for my variable nominal and ordinal? Then the question does not arise for nominal and ordinal. So reliability test, where you are going to factor analysis. In factor analysis, what is your variable? Scale variable. So there you can use it. So for my analysis, I am going to use chi-square test, where I am going to apply nominal data and ordinal, for which you cannot apply for the reliability test. Next question.
Yes, thank you, sir. The next question from Yema Malani. Is that necessary to have any one of personal data variable with dependent variable to test the association?
Oh, again, I have said 100 times, for testing the association, both the variables are categorical in nature. You should not have any scale variable. So second part, I'm going for association. That time you will be very clear. Next.
Yes, sir. That's all, sir, for the first question. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank
you. So I'll go for the second one. Okay. Right. So I want to complete very fast. Very fast. Say a test of association. Skysurf test of association. Okay. Right. I am going for Skysurf test of association. Here we are going to see two categorical variable. That is why I have given a separate time data and variable. So here I am going to take, what is that one? I'll just make it bigger. Right. Here I will take this one. Okay. Bivariate. So here it is a bivariate analysis, exploring the relationship between the two categorical variable. Categorical, please listen. The relation between Skysurf test association for, see, sometimes they are confusing. Correlation as a association and as a correlation. Yes, of course, it is a correlation only, but this is done with the help of categorical variable, but in correlation, we are doing the help of scale variable. With the help of categorical variable, you are not supposed to do correlation. It may be a Pearson correlation, otherwise it may be a Spearman correlation. You are not supposed to do categorical variable. If you want to do the association with the categorical variable, my research scholar, you can do only Skysquare test for association only. Right? Then Skysquare test is a non-parametric test concerned with the categorical variable. Right. Correlation, both pairs and the quality that already I have said. Okay, next one. Hey, what happened? It's not going. Right. Assumption is same. It should be independent. Every cell must be have a minimum 5. Then, what is the objectives of a Skysquare test association? We are seeing the presence of association. We are taking two variable, one categorical variable, another two categorical variable. Whether the two categorical variables are associated, is going with the, along with the other variable. No, sir. It is going one way, sir. This is going for another. This is the way we are going. No correlation, association is there. So in the Skysquare test of association, we are going to see, we are taking one variable here in another variable and testing whether you have a association or no association. So that's all. That is the main aim of that. So here it is called then binomial data. What is a binomial data? A variable having with the two attributes, other variable with the having other two attributes. That is called what? Binomial data. I will give you example also. A scholar wants to see the relation between job satisfaction and the absenteeism. Usually, if you have a job satisfaction, you never absent. If you have a less job satisfaction, you will go for a more absent. So that is the relationship. So see the objective. You see, do the job satisfaction or absenteeism are independent or dependent? Independent means no association. Dependent means associations. So that is the meaning. So what is objective? To see the relation between job satisfaction and absenteeism. What is hypothesis? I'm a little bit going very fast because of the time factor. Both job satisfaction and absenteeism are independent. Independent means what? Separate. Tani, no association. What is independent? Both variables do not have any relation. Research hypothesis, what? Both the variables have a relations. This is a research hypothesis. What is the null hypothesis? What is the null hypothesis? No relationship, sir. They are independent, sir. So with the help of one variable, you cannot estimate the other variable. When there is an association with the help of one variable, we can estimate the other variables, sir. So that is the things which we are going to see. So job satisfaction, yes or no? Absentees, yes or no? This test is the Skyscraper test of association, also called 2x2 contingency table. Please listen. Many of the research scholar doesn't know about the contingency table. 2x2. 2, 1 digit is nothing but one variable, which also indicates two attributes. Into other 2 digits, 1 digit is there. That digit is also one variable, will have a 2 attributes. Here you see job satisfaction is one variable with 2 attributes. Absentee is again one variable with 2 attributes. So that is why it is called 2x2 contingency table. Here, what is the IV and its attributes? Here, job satisfaction or absenteeism, which is the IV and so on. That is, you must be very clear. You see, job satisfaction, which influence. If I have more job satisfaction, I never absent. If I don't have a job satisfaction, I will go once in a while. So the job satisfaction is the IV. What is attribute? Yes or no? Okay. So what is IV in the attribute? Job satisfaction is the variable. Okay. IV should be recorded in the column box. IV. But it is not so very much important. You can apply this and that. But however, for understanding purpose, knowing the concept, the research scholar should know which is the IV, which is the DV. If the IV, if you identify, put it in the column box. If you identify the DV, you put it in the row box. Okay. Next, what is the DV? DV is the recorded in the row box. What is the nature of the contingency table? What is the nature? 2x2 contingency table, already we have seen. 2x2 contingency table, right? She framed the following question. Do you have a job satisfaction? Yes or no? You tick only. This is a open, this is a close-ended data. You are asking the respondent, you should tick either of these two. You are not supposed to write anything more than 2, anything more. So are you absent in your job in the last 6 months? Yes or no? What is the nature of the variable? Name of the, what is the nature of the variable? What is the nature of the variable? Categorical, nominal. Nominal variable with the 2 attributes. Test is Skyscraper test for association. Why it is association? Because we have taken 2 variables, one IV, one DV, and we are going to see, is there any association? Otherwise, no association, and so on. What is significant? 95% is a confidence, 5% is a significance level. Application. Next, researcher wants to know the relation between the skill and gender. Skill and gender. Who is having the skill in gender? Skill with have a 2 attributes. And the skill with have a, again, 2 attributes. I have not given, but in one population. Answer the following question. What are the nature of the variable? What are the nature of the variable? See, nominal, ordinal, interval, or ratio. This is a nominal variable. See, nominal variable. 2 nominal variables are there. What type of test will you apply? Association. Specify the form of common proper noun. Common noun and the proper noun. Hello? Common noun, Skyscraper test, proper noun, test for association. So don't forget, hereafter, whenever you are writing the research methodology, in Skyscraper test, I'm going to apply putness of it, association. Or like that way, you must be very specific. Then common noun, Skyscraper. Right? What is the IV? What is the independent variable? Here you see what is the independent, what is the IV and what is the DV? Specify the above test in the form of a contingency table. Here, what is IV here? That is a gender. Gender which influence the, improve the skill. Never skill will improve the gender. So DV is the skill. So specify that test in the form of contingency table. What is the contingency table here? 2 into 2. Right. The next application continue. How do you infer there is no relationship between the skill by seeing the output in the SPSS? By seeing the output, there is no relationship, because if the p-value is greater than 5, no relationship. If the p-value is lesser than 5, there is a relationship. That's all. Then next one, is there any possibility to infer the two variable has no association or independent without seeing the p-value? Hello, ladies and gentlemen, I will give you a clue. Go to the table in this cross-processing summary. If the observed data and the expected data in particular cell are equal, it is independent, no association. Then there is association, independent count, I mean observed count and expected count are varies. Then there is an association. When the observed and expected counts are same, no association at all. It is the system which I am giving this idea for you. Yes, you can. Can you possible by you? How? That's why I said how. That is by you compare this expected and observed. If both counts are same, it becomes independent. No association at all. Right. Your doctor wants to see lungs and the cancer. Yes or no? Again, 2 by 2. Okay, next one is other. See, social class. You see the social class. Here, social class and voting behavior. There are three types of class people. What is upper class, middle class, and lower income group people? Voting behavior, democratic, republic, social. Is there any association? What is association? Social party, the group people, I mean the middle income group people will vote for more on social. More on social. So therefore, the social party will be very concentrated, very particular about. If you calculate this type of association, the social party which concentrate for the next election, more income, middle income group people. Otherwise, if the lower income people are giving more voting, then they will concentrate on that. That is the main purpose for doing this type of association. Right? So here, this is called a 3 into 3 contingency table. Why? One variable, that's the social class, 3 attributes. Other is a voting behavior, again party is again 3 attributes. That is why it is called one variable, 3 digit, one digit, that is one variable with the 3 attributes into other digit, that is a variable with having 3 attributes. That is why it is called 3 into 3 contingency table. So this way you can go for 3 into 4, 3 into 5, 4 into 4, 5 into 5. Like that, you can go for any number of contingency table for this chi-square test, provided all are categorical in nature. Okay, next. Hey, what happened? It's going, it's not going. Next, nature of the variable. It is a nominal variable or ordinal? It is a nominal variable only. What is the nature of contingency table? 3 into 3, that is already we have seen. Okay. 2 into 2 contingency. Details of test analysis. Whatever test will you apply? Association. Why? They are categorical variable. There are 2 variables. Both are coming in the same populations. Can you frame the objectives and hypothesis to evaluate the relation between the lung cancer and the? Yes. There is no relation between lung cancer and smoke. Both are independent. This is the null hypothesis. Research hypothesis, there is a relationship. What is the guidelines? 5%. P-value is a 5%. Because in social science, they are always be 5%. Independent. Use the test of independent to decide the variables are independent or dependent. That's all. HO, the 2 variables are independent or dependent. Null hypothesis, again, the same thing which I explained. Residual. What is the residual here? Observed count minus expected count equal to residual. That if the residual is more, if the observed count is greater than the expected, plus residual. If the observed count is lesser than the expected, minus residual. This all you are, I will tell you in the output. That is why I am giving now itself. What is the residual means? The difference between expected and the observed. If the observed is greater than expected, plus residual. Opposite, vice versa, minus residual. Next, standardized residual, positive and negative. See, the residual will be converted into a standardized population. If you take this normal curve, in the normal curves, in the center point, mean median mode, 0 point. If you take right side direction plus or one standard deviation, in this left side, one standard deviation, if you take it, that becomes what you call 66% or 65 or 66% of the population. If you take other one standard deviation, two standard, here also two standard deviation, that is approximately near 1.96, but conventionally we can take it as a two standard deviation. If you take it, that becomes what you call the 95% standard deviation, 95% of the populations. So the standardized residual is converted into a normal standard form of populations. That is why it is very important. With the help of the standard residuals, we can go for more analysis. Hypothesis, again, the null hypothesis that the two variables are independent. Again, I am going to give Z score. This all you can know what is a Z score, actual mean minus population divided by standard population. This all I will tell you in the case of output. Pi value effect size. Here you see this is effect size grammar B. When the degree of freedom is increases, the small value will also will be less, or the medium size will be very more, right? That way you can go for Fonberoni correction should be made here. This is a very important one. I will tell you later during this analysis. Okay, again, I want to go for, okay. I'll go for this analysis. This is what you call this. I will close it. I'll go for data analysis. I'll go for data analysis. This is for skyscraper test for association, skyscraper GOMO. Right. This is for data files. Okay. One sample Vogaya homogeneity. This is for this. Here this is so for the skyscraper consolidated. Skyscraper test for post-op test. I will take this one. So I will complete only within these things. Right. Here you see what is this data you can see. This is a respondent. First one is the respondent, which we don't want to go for this one. Next one is a district. District, you see, I have selected some district. Where did the interview take place? Where did the interview take place? That is Kadalur district, Vilpuram district, Kallakurichi district, Tanjore district. Okay, this is one. Another one is, what is the next one? Do you use internet? Yes or no? That means let me know about, I want to see the association. Is there any more number of people are using internet? What is the internet usage in different districts? That way just I want to test. That is why I am going for using this Q test. My data are individual data. It is not a consolidated. You see, I have collected individual data. I have posted a individual data also, right? It is not a consolidated data. If it is a consolidated data, I should go for a different form. That also I will tell you later. Okay, right. Okay, now I will go for analysis, descriptive statistics. I'll go for crash tabs. I'll go for crash tabs. Here. Which is the IV, which is the DV? IV is the categorical, that is a district. This is a district. I mean, Vilupuram, Tanjore, and so on. Here, what is the, this is a request number respondent, and this is the interview take place. You can take this in a column. So independent variable, take it to the column box. Okay, right. So now, another one is a DV. You can take it into the row. Do you use the internet? So, but it is not the mandatory. You can reverse also you can put, no problem. But apply a system, procedure. Anywhere if you go, they won't teach this level. They will say, you can do any kalaya, you can arrive this or this level. But you can identify which is IV and DV. You put the IV into the column, you put the DV in the row, because this will have some importance. But later I will tell you if time permits, but the time is not sufficient. Already 5:42. Right. Now you can go for statistics. Click chi-square test. Here you see I said quality of research which gives Pi's test and grammar B. Right. So you can click. Then you can leave it the remaining column as it is. Go for continue. Next, cell. You can see the observed. You can click expected. Then unstandardized one. Then adjusted and standardized. Right? Adjusted standardized residual. Why so? Because why I given observed and expected? You find out the difference between observed and expected. You can find out the unstandardized. That is a residual. That is nothing but the unstandardized is nothing but a residual, ordinary residual. You can easily arrive by subtracting observed minus expected. And this is what I call the adjusted standardized is nothing but Z-score. Z-score is form of a normal distribution curve. To know the Z-score, we can go for this one. Next, continue. Then formal, that's all regarding this. Next, we'll go for this. We'll go for this case process summary. Here in case process summary, you can see there are 710. Missing is 4. So totals 714. Out of 714, 4 is missing. We have taken only 710 is the sample size. That will be very helpful for calculating this effect size. That is number of sample. Now coming to this next. Do you use internet into where did the interview take place? Here you see. See, Kadalur. What is the count? 160. That is observed count. What is the expected? 169. So the residual is -3. Why it is -3? You see the difference. 169 minus 166. The difference is 3, but it is given -3. As already I have said, if the observed count is greater, you will get plus value. If the observed count is lesser, you will get minus value. That is why you are getting the minus value. So correspondingly, the adjusted residual also, you are getting this minus. Okay. You take this one, Bilpuram. What is the observed count? 133. Expected 124. 10.6. Oh, Bilpur Bhattacha. Plus. So in the Bilpuram district, more people are using the internet. Right. So that is the, what is the more people? 10.6. What is the adjusted residual? 3.1. Here you see 2.7 minus here. 0.7. Here you see -0.13. I have said already, what is the minus value? What is the plus value? Here you see, no, that's all right. Now you can see here, chi-square test. What is the chi-square test which indicates? It accept the null or reject the null? It reject the null. Why so? Because the p-value is lesser than 5%. See, you can write this, you know, citation, writation, all these things. I applied chi-square test for association to see the difference, the association between these internet usage and different districts. This chi-square test value shows 9.7 with a degree of freedom 3, and the p-value is lesser than 5%. That indicate it reject the null hypothesis, accept the research hypothesis stating that there is a significant association between usage of net and different district. That is the answer only you will get. Please listen. So if you have done it, this is not the level which you want to do for PhD. If you have done it, this is a quantity of research. It is not a quality of the research. See, next, I will show one more test. That's a quality of research which will be improved. Here, you see. Here, you use the Pi test. Whenever you apply chi-square test for goodness of fit and 2x2 only for pi. Other than two test, you can apply Cramer's V. Again, I repeat you, if you are doing goodness of fit and association let 2x2 only, you take pi. Other than these two, what are the other than the two? 2 into 3, 3 into 3, 3 into 4, 4 into 3, 4 into 5, 5 into 5. So if you go for this type of association, please take the Cramer's V test to see the strength of association. The strength of the association. You can, this is also another important aspect. When you go for seeing this association, when you have a significant value, then only if you have a significant value, if the p-value is lesser than 5, then only you can see the strength of association. If the p-value is greater than 5, you are not supposed to see the strength of association. Why? Because I myself don't have any association. Why do you see this strength there? Right? So that is the way you want to do, right? Okay, this is the one quality of research. Then another one more important thing, which no one will do in India as a whole, I will tell you, 99% of people will never do beyond this level. Beyond this level, I will tell you. Just they can imagine. Otherwise, even after that, by taking my cell phone, let them bombard it, sir, I attend this and that. Okay, they never do. What? Post-hoc test in Chi-square test. Nobody, no one will teach you what is post-hoc test in Chi-square test. Somebody asked, what is a post-hoc test? Post test is a test which is done after one stage of significant. After one stage of significant. You see, listen, this is a very important one. Here, this association shows significant. What is meant by, see, you take, this is one variable with two attributes. What are they? Yes, I know internet. I do not know that. There are, in other hand, there are 4 districts. What are they? Kadalur, Vilupuram, Kallakurichi, Tanjore. So, in Chi-square test, if anyone is significant, it will give, yes, the test is significant. It is not necessary, all the 4 into 2, 8, become a significant. No. If anyone, if suppose if the Tanjore is significant, it will skew significant. Sometimes both Tanjore as well as Kadalur combined together, it will give the significant. That also gives. Otherwise, Kallakurichi, Tanjavur, Kadalur is significant. If all the 4 people are so significant, it will give. Or if anyone is significant, it will show the systematic method, it will show the Chi-square test significant. But as a researcher, who is different from who? Who is, what is different from what? That is the test which you want to identify after it becomes the significant. If it is not significant, you are not supposed to do the post-hoc test. The post-hoc test, yeah, test which can be done in the second line when the first line shows a significance. In the first line, this shows a significance. Therefore, I want to go for post-hoc test. Who is different from who? That way I want to see whether the Tanjore people is using more internet or Kallakurichi peoples are more associated with the internet or Vilupuram peoples are more associated with the internet or Kadalur peoples are more associated. So Otherwise, even sometime all the people are also more using this internet. How? When the observed count is more than expected count, is extraordinary difference, then you will have a difference in all categories. When the observed count and expected count is more or less very close, you cannot find more differences. So that part you want to identify. So we want to go for post hoc analysis, post hoc test in chi-square test that will give a further quality of your research. Okay, so that part I'm going to tell you here. You take the adjusted residual here, you see here. If the adjusted residual is greater than 2, greater than 2, not greater than 2, exactly 1.96. Why so? Because the adjusted residual is nothing but Z score. In the Z score, plus or minus one standard deviation, it covers 65% of population. Plus or minus 1.96 standard deviation cover 98% of the populations. So we want to test confidence level 98%, p value only 5%. So the adjusted residual is the Z score. If the Z score is greater than 2.96, or conventionally we can take 2, that will have a significant difference. By showing in the table, I will find out which district is associated. See, what is a chi-square test? Chi-square test will tell you there is an association, sir. But I will not disclose which district is associated. If you are so particular, you can do some other test and identify. So here, I repeat, this chi-square test, which indicates less than 5%, which tells you there is an association, but it never discloses which district is associated high usage of net and low usage of net. If you are so particular and very much interested, you can go for another that is called post hoc test. Post hoc test is the second line of test. Then the first line of test become a significant. This is the question which posted in this previous two session. That's why I am giving a very clear point here. So here, adjusted residual, you can see when the adjusted residual is 1.96 exactly, otherwise conventionally 2. What is the difference between 1.96 and 2 is nothing but 0.04. That is why you can take nothing wrong, 0.04 more. Conventionally, you can take 2. Okay, so here you see, is there any association between Kadalur and the internet usage? No. Why? Because the adjusted residual is how much? 0.8 only. It should be greater than 1.96 or 2 conventionally. So the Kadalur is no association. I mean, Kadalur with this internet usage are independent. No association. Okay, next. Coming to this Viluppuram. Viluppuram, you see the adjusted residual. Oh, the adjusted residual is 3.1. Oh, very good. Bilkul bagutacha hai. See, the adjusted residual is 3.1. What is the criteria level? I said 1.96, which covers 98% confidence level. But it has more than 1.96, conventionally 2 standard deviation, 3.1. So the color, the Lupuram district has a association with internet usage. That because of only in skyscraper test, you see, you have a significance level. Let us see the Kallakurichi. In Kallakurichi, what is adjusted residual? 0.7. Where? No association, independent. Why? This is 0.7. It should be greater than 1.96. It is lesser. So Kallakurichi peoples are not using that much independent. Okay, next, let us see the Tanjore. These adjusted one point, they are nearing. Even then, there is no association. If it is association, it should be 1.96. Okay, so that way you can give this one. You can identify, this is the first quality of research. After that, we should go for the second quality of research. This is second quality of research. Third quality of research is that which I don't have a time to explain in the worksheet. This itself is sufficient. You provide times more in next some more session. I will do it because here I am not doing this Bond-Baroni correction. Bond-Baroni correction. What is the Bond-Baroni correction? You are taking, see, you heard about the family error. You heard about the type one error. Some people, the dead snake, you know, some people may be bitten a snake and it become died. Again, some people take the same, again, the dead snake, they will slap. What is the use? The same way, here you are using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 tests. For 8 tests, you are using 5% significance level. So thereby, the confidence level is reduces. In social science, you should not reduce the confidence level below 95%. So that should be retained 95%, for which you should go for Bond-Baroni correction. Bond-Baroni correction, you have to do a separate test. That is by, you take this adjusted residual and calculate the significance value, and the significance value will be compared with the p-value. Here, the p-value should not be taken into 5%. It should be taken into 5 divided by 8. What is that? That becomes the p-value. That p-value compared with the significance value. So here you can take 0.021 will be taken as a p-value is equal to 5. But here you are not supposed to take 5%. You have to take 5 divided by 8. Why you want to take 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 tests are there. So you have to divide the 5% into divide. That becomes the p-value and should be cut. That all these things will be done with the help of the SPSS output. If you have a time, I will do it because already the time is 6, which I cannot, unable to do. Otherwise, if you say yes, I will do it. No problem. Hello, Dreyarasan, sir. Shall I continue? Hello, Dreyarasan.
Yes, sir.
Dreyarasan is there or not?
Yes, sir. The participation want to continue the session, sir. Yes, sir. Please, sir. The participation Hello? Like to continue the session, sir. Sir, can you hear my voice, sir?
Next. That's all regarding about this guy's test of association.
So sorry to...
Now sir, I go for no question.
Sir, once again, sorry to...
Whatever the question, which I will go for this question session.
Sir, okay. Sorry to interrupt, sir.
Hello?
Hello, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
What happened?
Hello, sir.
Chat. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Prayer sent?
Yes, sir.
What happened? Participants, chat. Prashottaman? Hello?
Hello, sir.
Hello, what happened?
Sir, can you use your headphones, please?
Headphone, huh? Right. Sorry. Okay. Yes. Come on. Now can you go for
Yes, sir. The participation like to continue only, sir. But it's sir, can you hear me, sir?
Eight minute. I'll come.
Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Sir, participation like to continue only, sir. But it's my humble request and also from the participation. Kindly drink some water, sir, please.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Yes, you let me complete this question, chat. Then I will go for this, you know, how to do it, this all these things. Can you go for chat? Question?
Yes, sir.
Please.
Session, the second section is very clear, sir. Only few. Question only the mention in the chat box, sir. First question from Dr. Muthu. How the values are changing in expected count?
How the values are. That is observed value minus expected value divided by expected value into chi square value. That is a formula. Ma. That is you have done in the chi square normal, no, by hand you have done. You know, the same way you have to, the system is also generated by itself. See, you are done in this chi-square test manually, observed minus expected divided by total or something else into chi-square, and you may calculate for each and every value. So the same way, the system is also calculate and put it in this box itself. Okay.
Thank you. Right. So the next question from Professor Sridevi. Is type 1 and type 2 errors appended in chi-square test? How to handle errors?
How to handle the type 1 error and the type 2 error?
Yes, sir. In chi-square test, and how to handle that kind of errors?
Yes. So, by way of using Pantaloni correction, when you go for multiple tests, see, even Hieronymus has said ANOVA. After ANOVA, they are going for post-hoc test. In the post-hoc test only, they are going for Pantaloni correction. What is a Pantaloni correction? It's nothing but adjustment of type 1 error. That is a family error. So the family error in chi-square test can be adjusted with the help of post-hoc in multiple comparison. And this chi-square test usually happen only in the post-hoc test, not anything else. When you go for post-hoc means what? Multiple comparison. In multiple comparison only, you have to do that type 1 error adjustment. That can be possible with the help of Pantaloni adjustment. That is why I want to give you that another 10 or 15 minutes. I will tell you if I do the SPSS working sheet. Okay.
Yes, sir. You can next. Go ahead, sir. Please.
Next.
Sir, the next question from Nageshwar. When to use generalized estimating equation.
Generalized estimate equation. Generalized
estimating equation.
Where it comes? Where I think it won't come in this chi-square test estimate. Generalized estimate equation.
Okay, so we can move on to next question, sir. How to do item analysis with the use chi-square test?
Item-wise analysis.
Yes, sir.
That is why we can go for multiple comparison. Item-wise analysis.
Yes. Okay. Next. Yes, sir. That's all, sir. The session is very clear, sir.
Very good. So, shall I want to continue that Pantaloni correction? Otherwise, shall I go for chi-square test for homogeneity?
Yes, sir.
That all left to you. Suppose if I want to go for this another, I will take another 1 hour only. If I go for only homogeneity, I can complete another half an hour. You tell me what you want. Accordingly, I will dance. I am ready to act.
So from the participation side,
yes.
So from the participation side, okay. So you can continue, sir. But as soon as possible, you can complete it, sir. Because okay. The participation requesting you take have some water also.
Thank you. I may forget.
Yes, sir. Please go for homogeneity. As soon as possible, we can complete and wind up, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So I don't want to go for this Bonbroni correction.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Whether I want to go for Bonbroni correction, then I should go for homogeneity. Otherwise, I want to skip the Bonbroni correction. Tell me exactly.
Sir, as you said, it's take 1 hour. Actually, our restricted time is only 4 to 5:30. Now around is 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock, yeah. Yes, that's why I said, see, the minimum is 3 hours is required. 3 hours to 6 hours, I want to take it here. Yes. I am taking only water, plain water only. I am not taking tea, coffee. Sorry.
Sir, no issues. Please take care, sir.
Okay. Now I am going to take the data file and this, what is that data file, the stuff association here, and post-op test. Oh, okay. This already is that. Okay. Let's stop. What sample consolidated? Okay, that is supposed to be right.
Right.
Okay. So now I am going to teach you and tell you how to do the Bonbroni correction. That is how to do the post-op test. Bonbroni correction is nothing but post hoc test. Why do you want to do the post hoc test? If in one line, if it is a significant, we want to go for the second line and see who is different from who. That way we want to see. So that part I am going to teach. Here, you can take this transform data, go to the transform data, compute the variable. Go to the transform data, compute the variable. Right? Now, here you can write down the target variable. Target variable is Z score. Right? That is a set score. Oh, right. So you can close it. First, you can develop a new data, then we'll go for these things. Right. Here, variable. Here, you can take Z score. Z score. Okay. Let's follow. Next, you're coming to this data file. You write down. You take down whatever the data that you are given. Here I will take minus 0.8, 3.1. I will tell you where did you get this all the information. 3.1. Next one is minus 0.7, minus 0.7. Next one is minus 1.3. 1.3, next one is 0.8, next one is 0.8. Is it audible, ma? Hello?
Yes, sir. Hello? Yes, sir.
Ah, right. Next one is this one is a 0.8, Next one is minus 3.1, 3.1. The next one is 0.7, 0.7. Next one is 1.3. What is this data? This is very simple. You can go to this output. Hello, you can go to, you please make a note of this figure. You can check up output. In the output, you can find out here, you see adjusted residual. You see here adjusted residual, minus 0.8, 3.1, minus 0.7, minus 1.3, 0.8, minus 3.1, 0.7, 1.3. This is the data. This is the value which I have taken. Only with that value only, we can go for Fanfroni correction. I already said. So roughly you can say by seeing adjusted residual, if it is greater than 1.96, you can see this is associated. But it is only the rough. It is not Fanfroni corrected value. It is not corrected with the type 1 error. If you want to go for type 1 error adjustments, this is the next step. We are going for type 1 error. Yes, now we are going for this one. Yes, now we had a Z score. Now that's from the Z score, we want to calculate the chi square value. We want to calculate what? Chi square value. Yes, now I am going to do that, calculating the chi square value. You can go for transform the data, compute the variable. You can, here you can write down chi square value. That is a target variable, chi square value. So you take this chi square value, the set score, you square the set score, it becomes the chi square value. You square the set score, it becomes the chi square value. You take it here into, again, take it, then apply. Where is the applier? Hey. It's always coming. Variable name contain illegal character, right? What happened? Variable name, chi square value, okay. Variable, let's go, okay, save, and go for output, and go for analysis, transform, and put the variable. It's there. Let's go. Multiply. Right. Now, are you got it, ma? See here, you can go to this input data here. Listen. Here you can go to the transform, compute the variable. Transform, compute the variable. Here you can calculate this chi target variable is called what? Chi square value. How do you calculate the chi square value? Set score into again, you square it. Then so I have taken set score and multiply into set score. You got this chi square value. Where did you get this value? This I will show the input. I will show it into the input data. You see, you got this chi square value. You see, you got the idea? Yes. With this chi square value, we want to go for significance. Significance value. How to calculate the significance value? Again, go to the data transform, compute the variable. You remove this chi square value. then p value, you write down the p value. P value, right? You remove this one. All these things are already over. Reset, we will go for reset. Reset, we go for p value. P value, yes. How to go calculate the p value? Just so you can see here. Here you can take, you come to the functions group. Please come to the functions group. In the functions group, you see the significance. You click the significance. You see the significance. Once you click the significance, you can find out this function and the special variable. Sky significant at the sky square. You got it. You got it? So here, what is given here, you see? Significant sky square, quantity, comma, degree of freedom. Quantity, comma, degree of freedom. This way you have to calculate. Okay. Right. Okay. Right. Okay. You got the significant and the sky square. So you take this sky square. Here, what is given? Quantity, the value. What is the quantity? This is the sky square value. You take it. You put it there. Comma, one. Sky square value, that is given. Why you want to give given one? Because we are comparing multiple comparison, two tests, two variable, one and two. 2 minus 1, one is a degree of freedom, is always one. So now you can go for, okay. You will be getting the significance value. Go to the input, see the data. See here, you get the data. You get the data, right? This is the p-value. This is the p-value of 8 tests. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How did you get the 8 tests? Because one variable is knowing the internet, yes or no, 2. Other variable is 4 distinct. 4 into 2, 8. So 8 tests are there. So you can take some more digits here. So in that case, you can improve that digits so that you will be getting some 5, 6 digits. Oh, sorry, not this one. You take the p value only. So 5 digits you can take it, nothing wrong. So, okay. So now you can see the data. You'll be getting this 5, 6, 7 digits answer, p-value. Now, this is the exact calculate. This is a calculated p-value for the 8 test. With that, we want to compare the critical p-value. What is a critical p-value? If only one test, we can take 5%. But we are not taken only one. We are taken 8 tests. So therefore, you have to take... Hello, ma, calculator. Ma. Asini. So what you want to do, you have to take 5 divided by 8. 5 divided by 8. So 0.0. Asini, cell phone. 0.05 divided by 8. You divided by 0.0, that is a 5% p value. But we are taking 8 test. And what is the? So if you take, so 0.05 divided by 8, this becomes what is called 0.00625. 0.00625. This is the critical value. So you can see now you compare 0.00625. Where did you get this 0.0025? 0.05 divided by 8. Why you want to divide by 8? Because 8 test. This is what I called Bonferroni correction. So you compare this 0.00625. Here you see which all less than 0.00625? Only this one. Only this one. Hi. Which district? Vilupuram. Vilupuram. You see? Vilupuram only. Okay. So here you may hand the Kallakurichi. That is a minus. Vilupuram peoples are using more internet usage because this p value is lesser than 0.00625. And these peoples who Kallakurichi peoples are using less. So there is an association in the Vilupuram and Kallakurichi. In Kallakurichi people, they are using less. Whereas in Vilupuram people, they are using higher. So this is the association. Kallakurichi people, that is why they are given the answer. Let us go to the, see the output. You see the output. You see the output here. You see adjusted residual. Where is that? 3.1. Where is that? Vilupuram. Vilupuram. That is the one. So not Kallakurichi also, it's wrong. Not I have taken the wrong information, I think. So Kallakurichi only plus 3.1 and no is a minus 3.1. So out of the three districts, Vilupuram peoples are more associated in the internet association. That's all we have to do with the Bonferroni correction. That's all regarding about this. Next, I will go for homogeneity of test. Hello, Durayarasan. Shall I go for Durayarasan? Shall I go for this next one?
Sir, I think all the participation is
any queries?
You hello, please, sir. Yes, sir. All the participation is respect.
Not clear. I'm not getting. Hello?
Yes, sir. Sorry, sir. The participation is requesting maybe the mobile charger and the data pack is clearing only. So I think this is enough to be point of this.
Okay.
Because requesting the person is calling for reducing data and not getting anything. So that's it.
That's why I said it's skipping this, you know, Bonferroni correction. I will go for homogeneity. But you said that go for this Bonferroni correction, then we can go for homogeneity. Yes. What I want to do? Tell me.
Yes, sir. We can wind up, sir.
Okay. If there is any question?
Yes, sir. I'll please check it and tell you, sir.
Yes. Please. Welcome.
Sir, since in the third session is very clear, no questions from the audience, sir. So thank you for your wonderful session, sir. Really, it's amazing. I'm really happy to say their participation. Sir has accepted our invitation for the cost of free during this pandemic situation. Sir, really, your session was really useful for all the participation. We are getting good responses in the chat box. So thank you, sir. So there's a session hand over to the Pooja.
Right. Shall I put some 2-3 questions in front of this respondent? If any time is there, otherwise leave it.
Yes, participants, is there any queries? Please post in the chat box.
Right. So I will put some questions. I will put 1 or 2 questions.
Yes, sure, sir.
Right. One. See, what is the different nature of hypothesis in your research? But do not say null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. Do not say null and the alternative hypothesis. What is the different types of hypothesis in your research? Please find out this answer for this. Who will decide the sample size? Whether the research scholar will decide the sample size, or whether the supervisor will decide the sample size. No, sir, both combining decide the sample size. Who will decide the sample size? In a Viva, I asked one research scholar. He said, I applied 450 samples. I asked, why you are very much particular about 450? Why not 451 or 449? Who decide the 450? You or your supervisor or combined? Do you have really the responsibility or authority to decide the sample size? Next two question, which I already said, why the p-value is 5%, it is a lesser or greater, already I have said. So in India, the researchers are doing the demographic variable only for histogram, by chart, and all this frequency, all this nonsense. See, you please move on to the next stage. Data analysis. Application of econometrics. How to apply econometrics with the help of demographic variable only. So, another one more last question. Can you frame hypothesis for factor analysis? If so, what is the hypothesis? So, for this question, you please try to find out the answer during your process. Thank you. My part is over. I will hand over to the online to this organizing people. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Pooja, take over the session.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. We are extremely satisfied with your session. You kept us alert with your lively talk. And every day meeting, there will be a feedback link will be posted in the chat box at the end of the session. So I request all the participants to fill the feedback form on daily basis. At the end of 7-day program, you will receive your certificate. So don't forget to fill your feedback form. Be thankful for all the gifts we receive every day. So I welcome Assistant Professor Kamala Devi Ma'am to render the vote of thanks.
Before that, sir, kindly stop present the screen, sir. Sir,
how to stop the present?
I think you just click the share screen.
Share screen. Wait. Okay. Then,
yes, sir. You click the share screen, then there is the option stop screen. Yes.
Stop screen. Right. Yes. Correct. Right. Okay, va? Is it all right?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right.
Yes, Kamala ma'am, you take care.
Yes. Thank you. Thanks for your invite. Good evening, one and all gathered here. It gives me an immense pleasure to present the vote of thanks. I am bound to render old-hearted thanks to resource person, Dr. G. Shanmugasundaram, who has accepted our invitation and made his valuable presence at this juncture and delivered key input with better usage of statistical tools and its techniques. Thank you, sir. I extend my sincere gratitude to our magnanimous management who have been with us from pillar to post in organizing webinar of this kind. My heartfelt thanks are to the respected director and secretary, Reverend Brother Dr. S. Arogyaraj, our academic director, Dr. Fatima Vasan, Principal Dr. Shajaj, Vice Principal Shift 1 Dr. B. Meena, Shift 2 Dr. Arogyamir Itadas, our head of the department, Dr. D. Unika. And I extend my thanks to Mr. Arunan, who introduced the resource person. My special appreciation and thanks to the student coordinators, Ms. Tiana and Ms. Pushkala Pooja, who is the MC of the day. And I extend my sincere thanks to the technical team, Dr. Durayarasan and Dr. Purushottaman. And I extend my And I thank my colleagues who have been with us in each and every context and stood shoulder to shoulder. Last but not least, it is my fortune to thank all the participants. Without you, this PDP will not be a grand success. Thanks once again.
Thank you, ma'am. So the another fruitful day has come to end. But don't worry, we shall meet again by 4 p.m. tomorrow to learn new topic. So always say yes to new learnings. Thank you all. And this is Pushkala signing off. And finally, stay home and stay safe.